It's blowing 25 knots of wind, but in half an hour we're gonna cross towards Pula, so then the race will be higher because it's really picking up already.
First time since years we have a morning like this.
We got an early morning visit from our neighbor. We're now on the part that's a little bit more open, so we have quite some big waves.
But do you have some tips for me as a father?
Yeah, you have to make one child more.
The best way to prepare this traditional Croatian dish is to add the ingredient music.
We are Rianne and Garben, and this is our son Benjamin. We made a few mistakes in life and experienced some challenges.
Cancer, bankruptcy, depressions, and a divorce.
They ignited us in creating our reality.
For now, sailing around the world to find our home somewhere on our planet.
So welcome to our weekly vlog, from raw sailing to slow living.
Embracing the race of life.
Good morning. It's a little bit cloudy and we have Deborah. We had a windy night behind anchor, but we also have good winds to travel towards Veles.
Yeah, so we're going to Pula. It's 35 nautical miles from here, from Losinje. Yeah, Deborah is blowing, so 35 up to 40 knots of wind. But we will pass behind, so I think we just with the Genoa make some good speed.
How many miles?
35.
And how long?
Let's say 5 nautical miles an hour. Okay. And but I think we will go a little bit faster.
And Benjamin found his new bed. Hello.
My yummy.
Okay, mama yummy. Time to make some yummies. No, but we're doing a final check of the weather.
Yeah.
And how is it looking?
Yeah, it's looking good.
Okay.
So we're leaving here and we take the wind up here and we have to go here. 26, 25 knots of wind. But it will die down a little bit like this. So good wind for going north.
Benjamin, shark shirt?
No shark.
No shark?
It's klein? Yeah.
Too small? No, you can fit this. Come. Yes.
Yeah. This one? Yeah?
First we have to dance.
Awesome.
faces. And then they see the dark stars.
It's blowing 25 knots of wind, but we are behind the island, so there are not a lot of waves. But in half an hour we're gonna cross towards Pula, and then we have an open piece of water, so then the waves will be higher because it's really picking up already. Benjamin, you like the waves? Big waves coming! Look over there!
So here it goes for some smooth sailing between the islands. We're now on the part that's a little bit more open, so we have quite some big waves. How big are the waves, do you think, Harald?
I think 2-3 meters. Sometimes they wash over, but they really roll underneath. So.
Big rollers!
Rollers!
Roll like this one. Oh, it's difficult to catch it on camera, but they are quite impressive. And Benjamin loves it. And we just had one big wave in the cockpit. And Gerber, yeah! Gerber, Benjamin, yay! A wave in the cockpit, right, Ben?
Yeah, yeah.
Beauty. Our next boat, Gerben?
Could be. It's a beauty. I'm not sure if it is an old
one. Old one or a new one, huh?
Yeah.
Very cool. But we survived our sail. We anchor now in a place that's like a kid's paradise. So, some fun for Benjamin. All set.
Anchor okay?
Got an early morning visit from our neighbor, and that is Leo.
Hello.
Hi, Leo. And Benjamin and Leo already made a friendship.
I think Leo is the older brother of Benjamin.
Yeah. Yes, and we're gonna take a look at their boat. They have a beautiful boat.
Yeah, built in the Netherlands.
There it is. So I'm very curious.
Okay, here we go.
Their boat and the inside, and we're gonna ask if we can film. Leo wanted to be in the film, it's okay. But we haven't asked his mom and dad yet. So let's see. And Leo actually follows us for already more than a year on YouTube.
Because you saw us entering yesterday, right?
Yes. And Leo is from Germany. And he has a mom and a dad and a big brother. But he's not on board, I think.
He is on board.
He is? Oh, he is!
I think he's sleeping. Oh, okay, let's see. Wow. This must be the man from South Africa.
Yes!
Good morning.
So Leo, when you saw us yesterday entering the bay, what were you thinking?
I was really nervous and I was thinking I will go to you, to the family.
I just heard that he wanted to swim over.
Yes.
Yeah. But he was not allowed to.
No.
We always like it when people approach us, but thank you for making the connection. Tell me something about your dad, because he's a sailor, right?
Yeah, he was sailing the Rolex Cup.
Okay.
And he was winning it, and yeah, he was a really good sailor. We comes in his life, and then he needs to stop it.
Yeah, but I think he's still a really good sailor, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, you like sailing with him?
Yes.
One day you will sail together with him?
Yes.
And cross the Atlantic?
Yes.
Yes! So this is the dad of Leo. His name is Marcus.
Marcus.
And we believe Marcus has one of the most beautiful boats here in the Mediterranean.
It's nice, but not the beautifulest.
Okay, not the most beautiful.
Okay.
Okay, we believe it's the most beautiful. But do you have some tips for me as a father?
Yeah, you have to make one child more.
Okay.
And then you have a big crew.
Okay. So that's the trick, so one child more.
Yes, you have two big crew members then.
Okay, yeah, strong ones.
Strong ones, you have to feed them well.
Okay.
Yeah. Drink them well.
Yeah.
And the hard training and practicing.
Okay. And can you tell a little bit about your sailing history?
Yeah, I started sailing when I was 4 years old.
Okay.
4 or 5 years with the Optimist.
Yeah.
I did the same like you. I sailed for 20, I sailed laser.
Yeah.
Then I start windsurfing.
Okay.
Because sailing was too boring on the on the lakes in Bavaria. We have never wind. And then also start windsurfing boring.
Yeah.
We go back to sailing and we go to Lake Gardasee.
Okay.
Yeah, and then I start sailing a Flying Dutchman with a friend of mine. And we get better, and I had a chance to get on a boat where it was a world champion, the Helsman, and we sailed pretty good in Lake Gardasee, and so I grow up and at least we were really good. We won the Kiel Weeks in 1991.
The Kieler Woche.
Kieler Woche, also in 92, where the Olympic Games were.
Wow.
And we won Gender Weeks, Flying Dutchman.
The Flying Dutchman. So that's the connection, the Flying Dutchman.
Yes.
So the real Flying Dutchman is here.
Yeah, we sail against, I think the name was Botsma, when I remember.
Ah.
Yeah? We also were second in Spa, in Medenblik. This was also in 1992.
And what's your dream?
My dream is to do this, what you are doing, to go over the Atlantic.
Yeah. With the family.
Yes. Yes, with the family, especially with Leo, because Leo liked to make a picture of the Freiheitsstatue in New York.
Ah! So we share the same, to drop anchor next to the Statue of Liberty.
Yes.
Yeah. We will.
We will make an appointment there, huh?
Yeah, that's it. Okay, thank you, Markus.
Thank you also, nice to see you.
English flag.
Thank you very much.
Wow. How cool is this?
Yeah, we are reflagging the boat and it's a bed sheet, but it's amazing. Thank you so much.
Yeah, you know, the always has to be in the water.
Yeah.
So yesterday I was waiting for more than 2 hours from Gerben and Benjamin with the dinghy.
Yeah, our outboard engine officially died. We tried to fix it. But our friends from yesterday,
hello.
They said, oh, we try to fix it, but it's really end of life. So they said, okay, we have another spare outboard engine and we will bring it to you and you can use it for a couple of days so you can organize a new one. Yeah, hello, Benjamin. So now they are bringing it here. So that's really amazing.
What are you doing?
Making some tea. It's getting colder now.
So indeed, it's getting colder. So today we're gonna do some cleaning of the boat, some swimming, and we're gonna try to explain why we're still stuck in Croatia and not going to Italy, because we don't want to lose our boat. We are really enjoying this. It's like the first time since almost years.
Yeah.
Since Benjamin's born that we have a morning like this.
Yeah, because Benjamin woke up at 6. And then I said, no, it's very early, you can go to sleep again. And then he turned and he said,
And he slept again.
Yeah, so this is really cool.
I don't know if you noticed this. What happened here? Benjamin bit.
Yeah, yesterday morning I was sleeping and Benjamin was at Rianne. And then he said, oh, let's bite daddy in the nose. And he did. And I was thinking, oh, just
small.
But he went, rah! So it was really bleeding. Yeah.
So cleaning her boat is what it
looks like. Hey Ben, you're gonna help out? Clean the boats?
Come.
And then Benjamin, feeding the fish? No fish, feeding the fish.
This is only the living room.
Oh, wow, Benjamin!
Oh, okay.
Are you doing the finishing touch?
Okay.
We finished up all the polishing of the chrome of the lamp, and now we would like to take it to a beach where we were already a couple of times, which is really special.
Come in. Okay?
Okay.
One, two, three, row!
We really love finding these places. Places that have a magical feeling. Places we can find, appreciate, and enjoy everywhere if we open our minds to it. With all we have been through, we know that happiness can always be found in the little things. When we couldn't pay our bills 4 years ago, we found happiness running around bare feet in fresh mowed grass, feeling the first sun rays and her warmth through our little window in early January. And something as simple as seeing the first butterfly in spring. This place where we stayed behind anger isn't extremely special or extraordinary, but this little beach is. A beach where everyday people come to make a piece of art in the sand, build little towers or make a sanctuary. A place where we are surprised every day with what we can find. One of our greatest life lessons that we practice every day, gratitude. Gratitude in the moment, in the evening before going to bed, and directly when we wake up. Even when life got really dark, we found that there are always things to be grateful for, and that gratitude uplifted our spirits. Always.
Actually really really excited to go sailing again. It's been 2 weeks only, but yeah.
Guantanamo! I can't wait to go to Italy. Ready for it? Fingers crossed that we have a UK flag registration soon. Make a stop at Pula, but today we're gonna sail towards towards Pula, and it's on the way to Venice. From here, from Losigne,